Michael is probably not going to tour again. You know, we're not going to do this extensive of a tour again. This was a very long one, very successful, biggest tour in history, played to 4.5 million people. But we'll never go and play another 120 dates like this and stay out for 16, 17 months. I mean, it's hard to do. You know, you're away from home too long. And if I had to do this again and gain another 40 pounds like I did this year, I mean, I'd probably end up dead. So, no, we're not going to do this kind of a tour. We will probably concentrate on films now. I think that's the natural step for him to take.
In spite of the physical and mental pressures of being a pop star, movie producer, and actor, Michael still found time to have some fun on the set with basketball's living legends, the Harlem Globetrotters. But even when he should have been resting, Jackson would still turn up on the set to check on production.
Michael is a workaholic. I mean, he works a lot. And that in itself is special because, you know, here's a man that could take the time off. Excuse me, he didn't have to really show up if he didn't want to. There were days that, you know, that perhaps he wasn't on call, but yet he came to be involved in the film. So I think Michael's, one, a great workman. Also, I feel he's the greatest entertainer of our day. And as people saw in this last story, he also happens to be the greatest dancer. And you'll see a lot of good dancing in the film.
At the end of the film, Michael gives us yet another burst of his mainstay talent. Come Together, the last segment in Moonwalker, is Jackson's first recording of a Beatles song since buying the music publishing rights and outbidding Paul McCartney for the valuable back catalogue of the famous four. But aside from music, what about Michael's future as a serious actor?
He will look for scripts for himself, and he'll also look for scripts to produce. So yes, he'll be active, both with the cinema and with recording. He basically records all the time. I mean, he'll be working on songs constantly. I know that for a fact he's written 4 or 5 songs while he's been out on tour. But to actually go in and start recording, probably not until, what year is this, 88, 89, around 90. We'll probably officially start an album.
Exciting, intriguing, and successful performers. And now he's making his first full-length motion picture, Moonwalker, and it's like nothing he's ever done before. A magical voyage into the world of Michael Jackson, Moonwalker is a story of the classic struggle of good and evil with some of the most stunning special effects, action sequences, and spectacular song and dance numbers ever filmed. Jackson, the co-executive producer of Moonwalker, was also responsible for much of the original storyline, and brought in Academy Award nominee, screenwriter David Newman, to bring his ideas to cinematic life.
The first movie I ever wrote was Bonnie and Clyde. And I also, with my wife, wrote all 3 Superman movies, 1, 2, and 3. And those movies, which, as you know, dealt with a lot of special effects and a lot of magic and a lot of superpowers, is something that Michael is very tuned into. So I think the combination of Bonnie and Clyde and the Superman Man films interested him.
Co-starring with Michael are Sean Lennon, son of John Lennon and Yoko Ono, Kelly Parker and Grant Adams, chosen by Jackson from hundreds of children who auditioned.
You guys got to get in the middle of this country.
And as the deadly Mr. Big, Jackson cast Joe Pesci, Academy Award nominee for Raging Bull.
I want you to hang out in the schoolyards.
But even with all the action in Moonwalker, some of Hollywood's biggest stars could not resist a chance to watch Michael dance. Gregory Peck showed up.
Here we go.
As did Robert De Niro. And Bruce Willis also. And one day, some unexpected visitors put on movie costumes to have some fun with Michael. Yes, they were the famous Harlem Globetrotters. To create the precise movements of highly trained soldiers, Michael called on the experts.
We're the UCLA silent drill team, basically, and our skills at marching and memorizing counts is what, I guess, brought us here, and we excel at taking orders, and we can make things look real sharp, and a lot of pop, and a little bit of military spirit, so it kind of adds, you know, credibility to our getup as Shadow Legion warriors.
Rehearsing for scenes where he shows Michael how it's done, Brandon Adams had an appreciative audience.
Look over here, run!
At first, these were really grown-ups' pants, and I feel like they took them and they cut them and they dragged them on the floor. And I like this because it's really cool.
Better spell my name right. L-I-B-E-O.
Acting with spiders in key scenes in Moonwalker didn't disturb Joe Pesci at all.
Smooth operation. That's what I got. Smooth operation.
Really?
Well, actually, I've worked with some actresses that were a lot worse. A lot more dangerous.
They're very fragile. They do bite. I saw one jumped on top of the other one and wrapped himself around him and took him down on the ground upside down.